Deadlift, king of lifts. This is the tutorial. I'm going to keep this video short and sweet. First, I'm going to walk you through two separate sets of steps that lead to a perfect deadlift. Now, I didn't come up with these two separate methods. However, they are the most effective ones that I have utilized as a coach and as an athlete that's deadlifted over 800 pounds personally. The reason I'm showing you the two separate methods is because simply different cues work better mentally for different people. So try them both out, and whichever one mentally clicks better for you when you're in the gym and leads to better form, that's the one for you. And in the second half of the video, I'm going to provide you with some cues that will really help your execution. And finally, I'm going to touch on some equipment. So let's get to it. The starting strength method. First, approach the bar so that your shins are 1 inch away from the barbell, placing the bar directly over the middle of your foot, and then slightly turn your toes outward. The width of your stance should be the same that you would use for a maximal vertical jump. Step two, without bending your knees forward, bend over and grab the barbell just on the outside of your legs. When you do this, there should still be an inch between your shins and the bar. Step three, bend your knees forward until your shins meet the barbell, dropping your hips down into position. Step four, flatten your back. Think about dropping your belly down between your legs. You should feel a little bit of the weight of the bar in your hands. Fix your eyesight on an object 12 to 15 feet in front of you. Push your knees out into your forearms, and then drag the barbell directly up your legs until you're standing straight up with your hips pushed through, your chest pushed through, and your shoulders held back. Then lower the bar the exact same way that you picked it up, down your legs and to the floor. Now, before we get to the second method, something vital that you need to make sure that you're doing before you lift each repetition from the floor is taking a big, deep breath down into your belly and flexing your entire core musculature hard. This is known as bracing, and it helps you lift more weight safely. Release this breath as you near the top of the lift and secure another as you begin to lower. Sebastian Orab, the Australian strength coach method. The initial setup and approach for this is the exact same. Bar directly over the middle of your foot with your shins 1 inch away, and then bending over to grab the bar just on the outside of your legs. From here, four simple steps. Butt down, knees out, scaps down, push the world away. And there you have it. Stand to a full lockout. Now, let's take a closer look. I'm going to break down some of these cues so that you make sure you're doing them properly. After you grab the bar and you move your shins forward, dropping your hips into position, do not move the barbell. If you do, the bar will no longer be over the middle of your foot and you'll be out of position. Next, when you push your knees out, you want your arms to remain straight. Don't push them out so hard into your forearms that it causes your elbows to bend. Next, when you flatten your back or scaps down, a great visualization that Sebastian gives is taking the crown of your head to the ceiling, not to be confused with bending your neck. Rather, simultaneously think about pulling your shoulders down to your back pockets, holding them there, and then pushing your chest through. Let's talk about the cue, push the world away. This is such a great one. It's probably the best visualization overall. Keep an equal and normal feeling of balance in your feet as you leverage the bar away from the ground. The first man to deadlift over 1,100 pounds in world history, Eddie Hall, says he likes to visualize the deadlift as leg pressing the world away from him. Now, let's talk about how to properly take the bar back down to the floor. You can think of this as two distinct phases. First, a Romanian deadlift down to just below your knees. Simply push your hips back, lowering the bar down your thighs. From there, squatting the weight down to the floor. Now, as I lower down, I like to feel the outsides of my knees and my forearms come into contact with each other. Everybody's body is built differently, so you may not be able to experience this cue. Finding the perfect stance width. Positioning your feet as if you were about to jump as high as you possibly could is probably optimal for transferring force from your body into the ground. I like to actually look up towards the ceiling and pretend that I'm about to jump. I instinctually move my feet into the correct position. Now, let's talk about equipment that may be helpful to you. First, lifting straps. They'll allow you to hold on to much more weight. Your grip strength will no longer be the thing that holds you back. And you can deadlift with a double overhand grip, which is always something that I recommend if you have the choice. Next, the proper footwear. This is always going to be a flat-soled shoe. Shoes that are thick and spongy, like running shoes, are designed to take your foot from point A to point B, and overall causes a downregulation of the amount of strength that your body expresses into the ground due to instability. And finally, a belt. This can help you produce more intra-abdominal pressure, protecting your spine as you lift heavy weight. I'll be making a more in-depth tutorial on this in the future. Until then, if you're looking for a program to build the body that you want, look no further. You can train with me in the gym every single week through my training app. I upload my exact training protocol with every single detail that I can provide. I test everything and perfect it. All you have to do is show up. If you're interested in training with me, just head to my website, myliftfitness.com. You have to sign up through there. It'll walk you through the process of setting up your profile, and then you'll be able to log in through the app.